One of the things I've always been interested in is unmanned aerial vehicles, or UAVs. Working with the paramedicine program and reading a few case studies on the use of UAVs, we wanted to actually do science and test this technology, this exciting technology, with paramedicine. So we did both a day and nighttime trial with 10 casualties, and at nighttime the UAV had a FLIR, or infrared camera. And basically we set up a 10-car pileup, and the first thing that any first responder does when they come to a scene like that is they want to make sure it's safe. So our first scenario was we injected 7 common hazards that could be at a scene. Yes. So the 7 hazards were unstable vehicle, fuel, women's placard, fire, active shooter, power line, and explosion potential. We did a trial where we tested one group of paramedics that did not have access to the UAV technology to identify those hazards. And then we tested another group of paramedics who had access to UAV technology. There was really no difference between how fast they identified the hazards. The thing that stood out to me, the arm that used UAVs didn't have to expose themselves to those hazards. They could identify them using the UAV technology without having to be exposed to those 7 hazards. The technology is coming, and we're glad to be one of the few educational institutions to actually be testing the science behind it. The Paramedicine Association of Canada has stated publicly within 10 years, a bachelor's degree in paramedicine will be an entry to practice. So we're poised on the East Coast to be one of the first educational institutions to develop a tailor-made Bachelor of Science program for paramedicine. One of the things that sets us apart is that 6 of the courses are built from the ground up for paramedics, and that's the first in Canada. It'll also provide a stepping stone if they want to do other things within the broad spectrum of paramedicine field later in their career.